The Mesozoic era spanned the time from around 250 million years ago until 66 million years ago. It included the more famous Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous periods. During this time, the supercontinent Pangaea began breaking up, and the modern-day continents moved into their current locations. It was a time when reptilians ruled the world, characterized mostly by the dinosaurs and flying reptiles. There was a huge amount of change to life on Earth. The geography of the planet changed enormously through this period, and as a result, the climate and subsequent animal and plant life transformed. At the beginning of the Mesozoic era, there were no mammals on Earth, but it wasn't long before the very first mammalians appeared. These were mostly shrew-like animals, small and insignificant in a land of reptilian giants. But they would grow and evolve into some of the most diverse creatures on the planet. Today we ask the question, could mammoths have survived the Mesozoic? The earliest mammoth to have roamed the Earth was the Mammoth subplanifrons, sometimes called the African mammoth. They lived from 5 million years ago during the Pliocene, long after the Mesozoic era had ended. They mostly inhabited South and East Africa. But subsequent species of mammoths were more renowned for their existence in colder climates. The Mammuthus genus diverged into several different species of mammoth that covered various areas of the globe. The steppe mammoth emerged in East Asia at the beginning of the Pleistocene. It then migrated into North America and Europe via the Bering Land Bridge and spread throughout the continent. It gave rise to the Colombian mammoth, which inhabited as far south as Costa Rica. They were known to hybridize with, perhaps the most famous of them all, woolly mammoths. The woolly mammoth diverged from the steppe mammoth 800,000 years ago and died out around 10,000 years ago. They were adapted to the cold. Although the earlier African mammoth lived during the warmer conditions of the Pliocene, its descendants lived during the Pleistocene, which was known for its cooler temperatures. This could be a reason why mammoths would not be able to survive during the Mesozoic. The Mesozoic appears to have been a stark contrast to the climatic conditions of the Pleistocene. It began as a very dry period, with extensive deserts covering much of the center of Pangaea. When the huge landmass broke up and sea levels rose, the climate became more humid. Deserts retreated, and forests began to grow on the separate continents. There was very little temperature difference between polar and non-polar regions during the Mesozoic, but there seemed to be periods of high rainfall. With so many well-preserved mammoths found in the permafrost, we have been able to find out a lot about these prehistoric animals and how they adapted to life on Earth thousands of years ago. Mammoths were adapted to the cold conditions of the Pliocene and Pleistocene. They had long fur and thick fat reserves on the tops of their necks to keep them warm. This was up to 10 centimeters, 4 inches thick, and also ensured they had enough energy to get them through the winter when food could be scarce. The tips of their trunk were not covered in fur, as they were used to graze and browse in the snow. In woolly mammoths, frozen specimens show they had an expansion near the tip of their trunk. It is thought that they used this to tuck the tip of their trunk to keep warm, as a kind of mitten, or even to melt snow to drink. Woolly mammoths also had mutations in their hemoglobin, which enabled them to deliver more oxygen around the body and prevent freezing. This is a characteristic found in today's muskoxen and reindeer. All these adaptations are not conducive to a warm climate. They would likely have overheated in the temperatures that were reminiscent of the Mesozoic. Of course, the vegetation was widely different during the Mesozoic compared to the Pleistocene. During the Triassic and Jurassic periods of the Mesozoic era, the dominant plant species were gymnosperms. These are non-flowering plants such as conifers and cycads. It wasn't until the Cretaceous that flowering plants emerged, which included grasses, something the mammoths would have eaten. Due to the relatively even climate across the globe, these plants spread towards the poles. However, scientists believe that mostly ferns and cycads dominated until after the Cretaceous period. The plant life of the Pleistocene when mammoths lived wasn't that different from today. There have, of course, been spatial variations since then, but the actual species present were similar. Young woolly mammoths nursed from their mothers for at least 3 years. Preserved milk has been found in the remains of a woolly mammoth calf, an incredible finding that helps us to understand the dietary behavior of these giants. They would gradually consume more and more vegetation from 2 to 3 years old. A fully grown mammoth could eat as much as 180 kilograms, or 400 pounds a day. and forage for up to 20 hours to maintain its enormous body size. They mostly fed on grasses and sedges, as well as herbaceous and flowering plants, shrubs, mosses, and tree matter. Instead of wrapping their trunks around long grasses and pulling them up to eat like today's elephants, mammoths possessed a two-fingered tip to their trunks, allowing them to pluck short grasses. Their feeding behavior and the food they needed would not have made them well-suited to the vegetation's sparse Mesozoic era, even as grasses began to emerge during the Cretaceous. But what would it have been like for mammoths to walk side by side with dinosaurs? They would have certainly been on the menu for many dinosaur species. In the Pleistocene, mammoths used their large size to defend themselves against predators. Often, saber-toothed cats would pluck off the ill or young mammoths to feed on, but it would take a great deal to take down a fully grown mammoth. The social behavior of mammoths was thought to be similar to modern-day elephants. They would have defended each other, protecting the weak or young, using their tusks to fend off any attack. But in the time of the dinosaurs, many of the predators would have been considerably larger than a mammoth. Their mammoth size may not have been enough during the Mesozoic era. Shoulder heights of male woolly mammoths reached up to 3.5 meters, or 11.5 feet tall, and they could have weighed up to 8 tons. One of the most famous meat-eating dinosaurs, the T.rex, measured up to 12 meters, or 40 feet long, and had a hip height of 4 meters, or 13 feet. They would certainly have been able to hunt mammoths and avoid devastating injuries from their characteristic, long curved tusks, as they were used to hunting triceratops. Of course, there were bigger and more ferocious dinosaurs than T.rex that would have been able to take down a woolly mammoth as well, and herbivorous dinosaurs had to develop evasive tactics to avoid being eaten. They either had thick armor-plated skin, long sharp horns, or were incredibly fast. Mammoths, however, likely wouldn't have fared too well in a land teeming with enormous meat-eaters. It was only when the non-avian dinosaurs died out at the end of the Cretaceous that mammals were able to flourish, diversify, and dominate the landscape. There's a reason there weren't any large mammals around during that time. Perhaps there was no way they would survive in the dinosaur-dominated ecosystem. It is also interesting to think what kind of impact mammoths would have had on the Mesozoic era if they had existed back then. They may have shaken up the ecosystem somewhat. Modern-day elephants are incredibly influential in their ecosystem and are important in maintaining biodiversity where they live. They have an impact on a multitude of different species, plants and animals, big and small. Would mammoths have changed the ecosystem during the Mesozoic era? They may have influenced the vegetation that emerged later on in the Cretaceous. Elephants can be incredibly destructive and destroy trees by stripping their bark or knocking them over to reach leaves and fruit. Would the fragile new vegetation have been able to survive herds of mammoths during that time? Furthermore, mammoths may have altered the predator-prey relationship amongst other species by providing more prey for the carnivores. Other prey species may have been able to thrive. Overall, we don't think that mammoths would have survived the Mesozoic. The climate was not suitable for them. Their adaptations to the cold would have hindered them in the heat and humidity. There wasn't enough vegetation until the very end of the era, and even then, they may not have been the right plant species for the mammoths to feed on. And finally, in a land dominated by giant meat-eaters, they may not have had the defensive strategies that prey species of dinosaurs had to survive. That's all for today! If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends. You can also leave a comment with what you would like to see in the following videos. Thanks for watching! See you next time!